This is Glorious Rain Christian Center South Africa. God sent Pastor Success A. Obanyagom to South Africa with the mandate of enthronement of kings and the restoration of the kingdom. As you listen, get ready for an impartation and an encounter with God. God bless you.
Jesus' precious name we pray. Can we give him a clap of praise tonight? Hallelujah. You are bigger than what I call you, Jesus. You are bigger than what people say. You are bigger than what people say, Jehovah. You are bigger than what people say. Adonai, you are God. Ola, you are God. You are bigger than what people say. Oh, Jehovah Rapha, you are. You are bigger than what we call you. You are good. Oh, Lord, you are God. You are bigger than what. You are bigger than what I call you. You are good. Oh, Lord, you are God. You are bigger than what people say. Father, Lord, we give you praise. Adonai, we adore you. We give you glory. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. Live up. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name. Tonight is going to be very strange. I was praying this afternoon, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon me the way I have never experienced it for a long time. And I believe it's for someone tonight. So tonight, as the word is coming, I will like you refuse to be distracted. Salvation is a personal thing. Praise God. Let your attention, listen attentively, and don't miss your time. Praise God. Just lift up your voice and say, Holy Spirit, let me not miss my time tonight. Can you lift up your voice and just talk to him? Let me not miss my time tonight. Let me not miss my visitation tonight. There will be deliverance. There will be healing. Let me not miss it tonight, Lord. My time. Let me not miss it. Let me not miss it. Let me not miss it. Let me not miss it, Lord. Thank you, Jehovah. We give you praise. We give you glory. In Jesus' glorious name. Hallelujah. Can we give him a clap of praise? Amen. Please, you may be seated. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. And all the time. So, yesterday, tonight I'm going to be speaking on healing for all. Somebody say healing. For all. Praise God. And if you are here tonight and there is somebody that is related to you that is sick, as the word of God is coming tonight, God is going to be touching them wherever they are. In the name of Jesus. And please, as I start ministration, I like movement to be restricted, please. Hallelujah. Now, yesterday we started talking about, we saw the theme of this program is total substitution. Somebody say substitution. Say substitution. So yesterday we said that substitution is the word exchange. It's exchanging something with another thing that has a higher value. Praise God. So we said that substitution is as old as the Bible. It's a very silent verbiage in the Bible, but yet with a very, very powerful significance. So we started looking at it from the Old Testament. We saw that substitution started from Genesis. In fact, the Bible says Jesus Christ speaking to John in the book of Revelation. And in Revelation 13 and verse 8, it said, for the Lamb of God was slain before the foundation of the world. So substitution started from the beginning of the world. Praise God. And we said yesterday that before your error, before you made your error, that the correction was already on ground. Before ever you sinned, the remedy to bring you out of sin was on ground. Praise God. Because Jesus was slain from the foundation of the world. So we started looking at it from the book of Genesis chapter 3. We saw when God created, we saw from chapter 1 the kind of destiny that God destined man to live. When God created man, he said, let us make man in our own image after our likeness and let them have dominion. Let them subdue, let them rule. And God blessed man. And God made man in his own image after his likeness. Praise God. So, but in the course of time, after God made Adam, the Bible said that Eve deviated, it was deceived by the devil, and they ate what God asked them not to eat, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And after them, their eyes were opened, the Bible says, and they made a fig apron from leaves to cover themselves. And we said yesterday that that signifies self-righteousness, which cannot bring anyone to God. Then we went further in Genesis chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. We saw that after God pronounced everything that he pronounced on them, yet God has to kill an animal. A lamb was killed and the skin of the lamb was used to cover them. So we saw God giving them a righteousness, an outer righteousness, covering them with the skin of an innocent lamb. A lamb that did not commit sin has to die for somebody that commits sin to live. Praise God. Hallelujah. Feel free, okay? If you want to vomit, go ahead. Hallelujah. If we should just leave her, just give her space. Leave her, praise God. Her deliverance is taking place. So we went further to Genesis chapter 22. We saw about Isaac, praise God. Just leave her, please, man. Just leave her. If we should leave her. Amen. Hallelujah. In Genesis 22, so we saw, talking about Isaac, when God asked Abraham to sacrifice his son, Isaac. So Isaac was taken to where Isaac was supposed to be sacrificed. And the Bible says that God told Abraham, Abraham took Isaac to where he was supposed to be sacrificed. So Bible said that God told Abraham not to lay his hand on the child, and God gave Abraham another substitute. Praise God. Then we also saw from the life of Joseph, then we said that all these are a significance of what Christ about our substitutional provision that is available in Christ. And we saw in New Testament that the Bible said that for God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him will not perish. So Jesus Christ came to give his life for our life. In fact, in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 21, the Bible said that he that knew no sin, God made him to become our sin. Praise God. So not just that he carried our sin, he became our sin. He gave us the life that we did not desire, for us to have the life that we do not deserve. Praise God. And tonight I prophesy again, in every area of your life that you are living short of what Christ has done, there will be a total substitution in the name of Jesus. Your shame shall be exchanged for his glory. Your sickness shall be exchanged for his health. Your poverty shall be exchanged for his prosperity. Can somebody shout a loud amen? So tonight, we are going to take it further, and I'm going to be dealing on healing. Now, you need to understand that wherever there is forgiveness of sin, there is healing. Praise God. Anywhere that God ever forgave, then God heals. Psalm 103, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgive all thy iniquities, and the next thing that followed, him that healed all thy diseases. So wherever God forgives, God heals. Forgiveness and healing are twin. Praise God.
So wherever there is forgiveness, there is healing. Just the same way that sin and sickness are together. Anywhere you see sin, you are to see sickness. But that is not to say that every sickness is caused by sin. But the one that is behind every sickness is Satan, the devil. Praise God. So now, when we are talking about, we said that Jesus Christ came to give us his kind of life. He came to give us, to substitute his life for our own. Now, before we be able to live out the kind of life that Jesus Christ gave to us, now we need to picture the kind of life that Jesus Christ had. Praise God. Now, the Bible is speaking in the book of Hebrews chapter 1 verse 3. The Bible says, can we open to that place so that we go slowly tonight? Hebrews chapter 1. Hallelujah. Somebody is being metamorphosed tonight. Somebody is being transformed from glory to glory. In the name of Jesus, whatever that has limited your destiny from shining, in these 5 days of glory, the hand of Jesus will take it out of your life. I thought I would hear a loud amen. The hand of Jehovah will remove it out of your life and destiny in the name of Jesus. Hebrews chapter 1 from verse 1. God, who at various times in various ways spoke in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son. So the life of Jesus is God speaking to us. He has spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed the heir of all things through him, whom also he made the world. Verse 3. Who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the Father of the majesty on high, having become so much better than the angels, as he has by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Now, in this place, the Bible said that he is the express image of God. In the Greek word, that word image is character. So Jesus Christ is the express character of the personality of God. Praise God. So the Bible says in Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 that when God said, let us make man, he said, let us make man in our own image, after our likeness. So for us to understand the kind of image and likeness that God gave us from the beginning, if you want to know it, just look at Jesus. Praise God. Because we are made in the image, and Jesus Christ is the image of God in bodily form. Amen. In Colossians chapter 2 verse 9 and 10. Colossians 2 verse 9 and 10. The Bible says that in him. Let's open to that place. Colossians chapter 2. Thank you, Jesus. Something will happen to someone tonight. Something will happen to you tonight. That amen is a sleeping amen. Colossians chapter 2 from verse 9. For in him dwell all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. In Christ dwells all the fullness of Godhead bodily. Verse 10 says, and you are complete in him who is the head of all principalities and powers. Everything that God is dwells in Christ. All that God wants you to have lives in Christ. The way that God wants you to look is in Christ. So if you want to know the kind of life and destiny that God has for you, just look at Jesus. Praise God. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Now let's go to John chapter 14. John chapter 14. John chapter 14. John chapter 14. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, take your place, Holy Ghost, take your
Holy Ghost, oh, Holy Ghost, 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 take your place, Holy Ghost, take your place, oh, Holy Ghost. Take your place, Holy Ghost, take your place, Holy Ghost, take your place, Holy Ghost, take your place.
John chapter 14 from verse 7. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. And from now on, you know him and have seen him. Now this is Jesus Christ saying to his disciples, you have known the Father and you have seen him. Verse 8. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father and it's sufficient for us. It will be enough for us. Jesus said to him, have I been with you so long and yet you have not known me, Philip? He who has seen me has seen the Father. So how can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father in me? The word that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own authority, but the Father who dwells in me, he does the work. He said, if you have seen me, if you want to know what God looks like, don't look too far. Just look at me. Look at the way I lived my life. Look at the way I dealt with the devil. Look at the way I mesmerized sickness and disease. That is the kind of life that God, because you are made in the image of God, that is the kind of life that God himself has for you. So when you want to know what God looks like, don't look too far. When you want to know the kind of destiny that God has for you, don't look too far. Just look at me and you will know the kind of life that he has for you. Praise God. Can somebody say, I have a life of glory? Say it a minute. I have a life of glory. So he went forward and said, the word that I speak to you, I am not the one speaking to you. It is the Father that is in me that is speaking. So when Jesus Christ was speaking, it was not Jesus Christ, just Jesus that was speaking. It was God speaking in him. When Jesus Christ was healing, it was not God. It was not just Jesus Christ. It was God that was healing through Jesus Christ. Praise God. Now, when you understand this, it is very, very important, because most of times, a lot of people want to ask themselves, is healing the will of God or is it not the will of God? Tonight, I am going to kill that ideology out of somebody's mind in this place. Praise God. Now, let's turn to Acts chapter 10. Acts chapter 10. Acts chapter 10. Even while I'm speaking now, somebody came into this place with a lump, and that lump is dissolving right now. It is dissolving right now. It is dissolving right now. In the name of Jesus. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. If you are there, can you say amen? How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. Now look at me. How God, who anointed Jesus? Come on, talk to me, church. Who anointed Jesus? Who anointed him? God. And the Bible said how he was anointed and he went about doing good. So, and Jesus Christ says that the work that I do, I am not the one doing the work. It is the Father that is in me that is doing the work. Praise God. So God anointed him. So when Jesus was doing good, it was God that was doing good through Jesus. When Jesus was healing, it was God that was healing through Jesus. Now, God cannot be the one that gives sickness and at the same time be the one that heals. Praise God. God cannot be the one, because there are a lot of people that say, you know, why God? God is the one that has given me this sickness. God is the one. No, God is not an author of confusion. The Bible says that light and darkness cannot dwell together. Bitter water and sweet water cannot flow out of the same fountain. Praise God. So God cannot be giving sickness and at the same time healing it. Praise God. Now let's read it and finish it. He said, how God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost and with power. With the Holy Spirit and with power. Who went about doing good, healing how many people? Answer me, how many people? How many people? All. So healing is for all. He was healing all that we are oppressed by who? By who? By who? So, sickness is a direct oppression from the devil. The one that gives sickness is not Jesus. The one that gives sickness is not God. Sickness is a direct oppression from the devil. And everything the Bible said that my heavenly Father has not planted, it shall be uprooted. Every oppression in your life that is not of God, tonight I command it to be uprooted in the name of Jesus. It's a direct oppression of the devil. It's a direct oppression of the devil. So the devil is the one that oppresses with sickness. Behind every sickness is the work of the devil. Satan is the one that is behind every sickness. So that is why you cannot entertain sickness or say, no, God wants to teach me lesson with it. No, God does not teach lesson with sickness. Praise God. You know, there is one word we used to use in the church. They say, you know, I am sick because God is chastising me. And in the course, as I was preparing for this, now most of us say it without ever taking time to find out the meaning of chastisement. The word chastising came from the Hebrew word educate or train. Praise God. So God trained people, but there is no mother or any father that want to train the child and want to train the child by putting the child, the hand of the child in the fire. Praise God. So the one that oppresses is the devil. Now look at Luke chapter 13. Luke chapter 13. Luke chapter 13. After tonight, no sickness, we know your address again. No sickness, we know your house again. In the name of Jesus. Luke chapter 13 from verse 10. Now he was teaching, just like as the word of God is coming now. Because I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. He sent his word and his word healed them. Praise God. And now he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. And behold, there was a woman who had a spirit of infirmity. 18 years and was bent over and could no way loose herself up. But when Jesus saw her, he called her to himself and said to her, woman, you are loose from your infirmities. And I pronounce anywhere you have been bound, I command you to be loose tonight. Anywhere your finance has been bound, I command it to be loose tonight. Anywhere your favor has been bound, I command it to be loose tonight. Anywhere your family has been bound, I command it to be loose tonight. Whatever that has to do with you that has been bound by the anointing of the Holy Ghost tonight, I command it to be loose in the name of Jesus. You are 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 loose in the name of Jesus. Somebody say yes. And he called and said, you are loosed from your infirmity. And he laid his hand on her. And as the word is coming, Jesus will be laying hand on your destiny tonight. You may not see the hand. He's going to be laying hand on your finances. He's going to be laying hand on your children. He's going to be laying hand on everything that has to do with you. He's going to be laying hand on your job, on your career, on your business, on your family. The Lord Jesus will lay hands on you in the name of Jesus. And he laid his hand on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. But the rulers of the synagogue answered with indignation, because Jesus has healed on the Sabbath, and said, and he said to the crowd, there are 6 days on which men ought to walk. Therefore, come and be healed on, and therefore come and be healed on them, and not on the Sabbath day. This were the Pharisees saying to the people. The Lord then answered him and said, hypocrites, does not each one of you on the Sabbath day loose his ox or donkey from the store and lead it away to water it? So ought not this woman, being the daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has bound? Who bound this woman? Who bound the woman? Answer me, who bound the woman? It was Satan that bound her. It was not God that was teaching her any lesson. It was not God that was trying to chastise her. No, it was Satan the devil that bound the woman. Behind every cancer is Satan the devil. Behind leukemia is Satan the devil. Behind HIV is Satan the devil. Behind arthritis is Satan the devil. And whatever the devil has put in your body that is not of God, I command them to wither away in the name of Jesus. I command healing into your body in the name of Jesus. I command it to be uprooted in the name of Jesus. It was Satan that bound the woman. God is involved in the business of healing, not in the business of bounding people. Praise God. God is involved. Even from the Old Testament, we read the greatest health account concerning the people of God in Psalm 105 verse 37. He delivered them with silver and gold, and there was no one feeble person among their tribe. There was no one that was feeble. There was no one that was sick. There was no one of them that was having arthritis or cancer. He took sickness away out of them when they walk in the covenant. Praise God. When they walk in the covenant. When they walk. Now we see God making an eternal declaration in the book of Exodus chapter 15. Can you open to that place? Exodus chapter 15 and verse 26. Exodus 15 and verse 26. This is the word of the eternal God. Exodus 15 and verse 26. And God said, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight and give ear to his commandment and keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases on thee. Praise God. I will put not. Now that word put is a misinterpretation. Praise God. It's a mistranslation. If you read it from the Vine dictionary, the original word is I will not permit. Praise God. I will not permit any of these diseases that I have permitted upon the Egyptians. Now the question is, if God permits sickness, does that mean that sickness comes from God? No. The Bible says, I will not permit. God may permit it, but God does not commission it. Did you hear that? God may permit it, but God does not commission it. Pastor, how do you mean? Now, almost many of us in this place are mothers and we are fathers. How many of you has ever had your child disobeyed you? You say, don't go out of the door. And the child went out of the door. Can I see your hand?
Can I see your hand? It happens to everyone. So, praise God.
You have your child, your daughter, or your son. You say, don't go out of the door. And as you turn, the child escape. Or you say, look at that biscuit there. Don't touch that biscuit. And you turn, before you know, one biscuit has missed. Now, what happens is that you, because the child is a free will agent. Praise God. Just like every one of us has free will. Now, if the child does not have free will, or you and I does not have free will, we will become robots. And God does not make robots. Praise God. Now, when you put the biscuit there, and you give the child a command, don't touch the biscuit. You turn, the child touch the biscuit. Now, you have indirectly permitted it because you put the biscuit there. But you did not commission the child to touch the biscuit. Praise God. Did you understand that? You put the biscuit there. You gave the child. No, don't obey. Just like every one of us, that at times, God said, don't do this. We go ahead. We went ahead and did it. Now, the reason God permitted it, because God gave us a free will, a free choice, but not that God commissioned it. So the same way God gave the children of Israel a commandment. He said, if you live according to my commandment, I will not permit this disease to come upon you. Why? Because disease is already in the world. Right from the fall of man, disease was now reigning. Because the person that was behind the fall is Satan the devil. And as long as Satan the devil is in the world, there will be sickness in the world. So God said, when you obey me, I will not permit. The same way that I have permitted it on the people that are in the world. Egypt is the world. So the same way that I permitted it in the world, because they are not walking in covenant. They are not walking in the law of God. So it can happen to them. But today, what do we have in the church? We have people that we want to equal ourselves with the unbelievers. If an unbeliever have cancer, we say God permitted it. Therefore, as a child of God, you can now permit cancer in your body. Somebody said to hell with the devil. To hell with that devil. So sickness does not come from God. Praise God. Now turn a bit forward. Exodus 23. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Exodus 23. And look at verse 25 and verse 26. So you shall serve the Lord, you are God. And he will bless your bread and your water. Somebody is leaving this place with a blessing. That amen is a sleeping amen. You are living here for your bread to be blessed. You are living here for your water to be blessed. You are living here for everything that has to do with your house to be blessed. Can somebody say a loud amen? And I will take away. Is it like that in your Bible? I will do what? Come on, shout it. I will do what? Somebody say, take away. I will take away sickness from the midst of you. So sickness is already in the midst of man because of the fall. Praise God. So Jehovah God, the Lord that healeth us, he says, if you will serve me and obey me, I will take sickness away. Not that I will put it. I will take sickness away from the midst of you. No one shall suffer miscarriage or be barren in the land. Get ready, you are about to experience fruitfulness. Fruitfulness in the work of your hand. Fruitfulness in your office. Fruitfulness in your business. In the name of Jesus. And you shall not be barren in your land. And I will fulfill the number of your days. I will send my fear before you. And I will cause confusion among all the people whom you come. And I will make all your enemies turn their back to you. This is the covenant of God in the Old Testament. Praise God. If you walk before me I will take sickness away from the midst of you. So sickness does not come from God. Praise God. It does not. So you have to fight sickness the same way that you fight sin. You have to fight sickness the same way you don't want to be poor. You don't entertain it. No. Sickness is not a blessing. Sickness is a curse. And if it's a curse, you have to reject it. Praise God. You have to reject it. You have to reject it. Now, in Deuteronomy chapter 7. Deuteronomy chapter 7. I want to give you more than enough scripture. Deuteronomy chapter 7. From verse 12. Then it shall come to pass, because you listen to this judgment and keep and do them, that the Lord your God will keep with you the covenant and the mercy which he swore to your father. And I will love you and bless you and multiply you. I thought somebody would say amen. He will also bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of your land, your grain and your new wine and your oil, the increase of your cattle and the offering, offspring of your flock, in the land of which he swore to your father to give you. You shall be blessed above all people. I thought somebody will shout. Somebody is about to be lifted. I don't know where you are now. The hand of Jehovah is about to take you to the next level. You are about to be lifted above your contemporaries. You are about to be lifted above your enemies in the name of Jesus. Can somebody shout a loud amen? I will bless you above all the people. There shall not be a male or female barren among you or among your livestock. So it means your cattle cannot be barren. Your rat, if you have one, cannot be barren. Your dog, if you have one, cannot be barren. Your cat cannot be barren. Praise God. And the Lord will take away from you all sicknesses, HIV, arthritis, headache, whatever you call it, and will afflict you with none of these terrible diseases of Egypt which you have known, but will lay them on those who hate you. We put them on those that hate you. So anyone that hates you should be very careful. Praise God. He will take them away. He will take them away. Praise God. He will take them away. And tonight he's taking it away. I say he's taking it away. He's taking it away. He's taking away emotional problem tonight in the name of Jesus. Maybe you are here and you are carrying emotional burden. Maybe you are here and you are bound to addiction that you cannot come out from. Tonight they are being taken away from you. The addiction to tobacco, the addiction to drugs, the addiction to alcohol, the addiction, Jehovah is taking it away from you right now in the name of Jesus. He's taking it away from you right now in the name of Jesus. Everything that is not of God that has taken hold of your life, I break their grip over your life. I break the grip of the devil, the bondage of the devil, I break it by the anointing. It shall come to pass on that day that the body shall be lifted off the shoulder and the yoke of the neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed by the anointing, by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Every bondage of the devil, I command it to be destroyed right now in the name of Jesus. I command it to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every bondage on your family, every curse on your family, I command it to be destroyed. The bondage of poverty, the bondage of lack, it is destroyed now in the name of Jesus. Everything that is holding you tonight, they are broken in the name of Jesus. 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 Somebody shout, I am free. Shout it, I am free. Shout it, I am free. Shout it, I am free. Push out the ladder. I don't know. God is healing an eye problem right now. Eye problem. He's taking it away from you. In the name of Jesus, he's taking it away from you. In the name of Jesus, I command your sight to be corrected now. I take authority over that devil of short-sightedness. I take authority over that devil of glaucoma. In the name of Jesus, I command your eyesight to be corrected. Let your lens be cleansed right now by the precious blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So he said, I will take it away. Now turn with me to the book of Isaiah 53. Isaiah 53. From verse 1. Who has believed our report, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He has no form or comeliness, and when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrow and acquainted with grief, and we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him. Now look at, watch from verse 4. Surely he has borne our grief and carried our sorrows. I thought somebody will rejoice. He has borne our grief. Now that word, borne, he has borne. The Greek, the Hebrew translation of that word, it came from the root word nasa. The word nasa. That word nasa means to carry away. Praise God. To carry away. So, the Bible says that he carried away, he nasa, my grief. The word grief is the word koli. It means pain. He carried it. He carried, he nasa, my colleague. And he carried away. The word sorrow is the word makob. Praise God. So he carried away, he nasa, my pain. He carried my grief. Whatever that should give me pain, arthritis, our grief, he nasa'd it away. Heartbroke, our grief, he nasa'd it away. High blood pressure, our grief, he nasa'd it away. He carried it away. He carried it away. He carried it away, my trouble. He carried it away, my barrenness. He carried it away. He carried it away. Somebody shout, he carried it away. Shouted, he carried it away. Shouted, he carried it away. Leka shatalabaya. If I were you, I will give him praise. I will give him glory. Lord, thank you because you carried it away. He carried it away. Not that he managed it for me. No. And not that he bandaged it for me. He carried it away. HIV, he carried it away. Tuberculosis, he carried it away. He carried it away. So, when Jesus was on the cross, thank you, Holy Ghost. When he was on the cross, and when they were nailing him, he was carrying my arthritis. He was carrying my HIV. He was carrying my headache. He was carrying my tuberculosis. He was carrying every disease that I will ever have. Every disease that we ever attempt to come to my body. He carried it on the cross. So if he carried it, if he nasa'd, somebody said nasa, somebody said nasa, somebody said nasa. So if he carried it, it means that I cannot have it. Praise God. I cannot. If I carry this thing away now, does she have it? No. So he carried it away from me. He carried it. I don't have it. If the devil is trying to force it on me, because he is the one that oppresses. He went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed. So if the devil wants to oppress it on me, what do? I have to resist him. He said in James chapter 4 verse 7, resist the devil and he will flee from you. So I have to resist him. I have to say, no, Satan, this body is not your dumping ground. You cannot dump HIV on this body. You cannot dump tuberculosis on this body. You cannot dump sickness on my children. It has been carried and you have no right to put it again. He carried it away. He carried it. He carried it, praise God. Somebody say he carried it. Somebody shout, he carried it. Shouted, he carried it. And as I am speaking now, maybe you are here and you have terminal disease. They are being carried away right now. If you have HIV, I command you to be healed in the name of Jesus. I command your blood to be cleansed right now in the name of Jesus. Every substance in your body, I command it to be flushed out right now in the name of Jesus. Under this anointing, you are listening by CD. I command it to be wiped out in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, he carried it away. He carried it 2,000 years ago. Hey, I can feel something in this place. He carried it. If he carried it, I cannot carry it. If he took it away, I cannot take it back. He took it away. My sin, my sickness, my pain, my barrenness, my poverty. He carried it away. I cannot. I refuse to have it. I refuse to take it back. I refuse. He carried it away. He carried it. And he didn't just end there. He didn't just carry it and leave us. Can we read it down? He didn't just carry it and leave us. Let's finish the verse 4. Let's finish it. Come on. Oh, my God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Ah, he bore our grief and carried our sorrow. Yet, we did esteem him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted, but he was wounded for my transgression, not his own. So he suffered for me. It was for my transgression. So when they were whipping his body, when they were tearing his body open, it was my body they were tearing. When they were beating him, when they spied on his face, he received all those things from me. So if he has received it from me, I refuse to receive it again. I refuse it. I refuse. Somebody say, I refuse. Shout it, I refuse. Shout it, I refuse. He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised. He was bruised. That word bruised means to be squeezed. He was squeezed for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we are healed. We are healed. We are healed. Somebody shout, we are healed. Somebody is being healed of poverty right now. Somebody is being healed right now. Somebody is being healed. Somebody is receiving family deliverance. Somebody is being healed. Somebody is being healed. Shout, yes. I thank you, Jesus. By his stripes, we are healed. Whether the devil like it or not, we are healed. We are healed. We are healed. We are healed. Then when you go to Matthew now said, he said that it might be fulfilled. Matthew chapter 8 verse 17. He said that it might be fulfilled, which was written by prophet Isaiah, saying himself took. Now, referring to the back, himself took my infirmities and carried all my diseases. In South Africa, took is took. In America, took is took. In Nigeria, took is took. In Korea, took is took. In the Arab world, took is took. He took it. If he took it, I cannot. And as I like to humorously say, if he took it, he has taken it. Praise God. If he took it, he has taken it. And I cannot take it back. He took it. He took it. Praise God. If he took it, he has taken it. So I cannot take it back again. Now, this is why I caught this scripture and I said, I can never be sick. You know, when Jesus Christ, when he finished, the Bible says that he sealed the covenant by his blood. So, if you are a child of God and you understand this, you can live all the days of your life without being sick. Is somebody hearing me? Divine health is your portion. You are not supposed to be sick, no. You don't need to be sick when it's time for you to go and be with the Lord. You don't need to be sick. Jacob was never sick. He just called his children, bless all of them. And after blessing them, say, you know, another door is open to me. Folded his leg and just transmitted to the other side. That is God's plan for us. Sickness is an enemy. So you have to fight it like an enemy. Praise God. It is an enemy. Jesus Christ went everywhere. There is nowhere, read the whole Bible, there is nowhere you see Jesus Christ seeing somebody that have headache and look at the person and say, bless you, you are in the will of God. Bless the person and say, you are so blessed, you are so much walking in the will of God. No. Anywhere he saw sickness, he took it away. He saw a woman that bowed down. He says, rise, stand up and stand straight. The man stood straight. He saw a man that had been on the pool for 38 years. He looked at the man. The man said, I have nobody to put me in the pool. He said, now the pool has come to meet you in person. Rise up and walk. Come on. After tonight, what you cannot do for yourself, the hand of God will do it for you. Is somebody hearing me in this place? You have been waiting for people to come to you. Right now, the Lord will take you to the people. If you cannot go to the people will come to you. You are here, you have been believing God for a contract. And the people, you go there and they rejected you. Very soon, they will come to you. In the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, yes! The pool came to the man. I will deal with that. That is heavy. The pool came to the man. Praise God. The pool. Pastor, what do you mean? He said, on that last day, John chapter 7 from verse 37, Jesus Christ stood and cried out, if anyone is thirsty, let him come to me. And those that drink from me, out of their belly shall flow rivers of living water. It was a pool. Out of them shall flow rivers of living waters. And the Bible said, by this he meant the Holy Spirit, that they will receive, but by this time they have not received it, because Jesus was not yet glorified. In Psalm 46, verse 3, it says, for there is a river in the city of God that will make the people of God glad. God is in the midst of her. There is a river, Psalm 46 and verse 3. So the river went to be with the man. Since you cannot wash yourself in the river has to wash you, even while you are not inside. Sickness is not of God. He saw a man that the hand was withered. He looked at the man, stretch your hand. The man stretched his hand. Mark chapter 2, there was a man that was bought by four people. And when they didn't find a place to come in, the Bible said they brought the person from the ceiling. He looked at the man. He said, your sin has been forgiven you. Now rise up, take up your bed and walk. There is no place he saw sickness. And you look at the person and say, you are so much in the will of God, or God is teaching you a lesson. From today, reject that. That is philosophy and religion in the church. It is not scriptural. God is a healing God. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, is the same today, is the same forever. I am the Lord God, I change it not. Therefore, you children of God cannot be consumed. If God ever healed, he's still healing today, and he will heal forever. And I announce to you, you are healed in the name of Jesus. 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 Your finances is receiving healing now in the name of Jesus. You are healed. 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 I don't know somebody's company. I don't know. Oh, the Holy Ghost just took me out from there. I don't know somebody's company that has been blacklisted. But right now, the blacklisting has just been lifted. That ban has been lifted. It has just been lifted now. Jehovah just lifted it now. He just lifted that ban in the name of Jesus. Where the blacklisted your company, the name has just been lifted. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet. My time is up. Stand to your feet. Lift up your voice as we appreciate him. Lift up your voice and give him praise. Lift up your voice and give him glory. Lift up your voice and bless him. Open your mouth. Lift up your voice. Lord, I thank you. He nasad it away. Lift up your voice and give him praise. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. There is glory in this place. Lift up your voice and bless him. Come on. Open your mouth and bless him. Give him praise. Lord, I give you praise. Le katalabada kosalada baya. E kose katalabada duzaya. Le bragada baya. Le kosalada baya. Lift up your voice and bless him. 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 Come on. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Give him praise. Give him praise.
If this message has blessed you and you'd like to share your testimonies, come worship with us at